So actually right behind me is the Peace statue.
I spent my time watching the spaces that have grown between us, and I cut my mind.
Good morning everyone, so we slept here at Kojo's house last night and just enjoying a hot coffee while adoring the beautiful view of the city there down in the distance. But today we might be catching some public transport into the city to go to the Nagasaki Atomic Bomb Museum, learn about the history of the bomb that went off here in 1945, the 9th of August at 11:02:35 a.m. It'll be cool to learn a little bit about the history of it and how this city had to endure. We're now making our way down into the Nagasaki city. Check out this museum. It's wonderful. They've got like basically no choice but to build on this valley and on this hill. And there's just houses just so steep up that it's really hard to access.
We could fly to the moon, get there by tomorrow. Think I love you. I'm red, look inside, check out all the things I try.
So we just got off the tram and we're actually going to make our way to the museum right now. So this is where we are right now. The museum's over here.
Chicken eyes, we play in the stars when the sun comes up. Get into my bed.
So we're actually now at the Nagasaki Peace Park, which commemorates the atomic bombing which happened in 1945. It's home to a massive peace statue and other memorials as well. Oh wow, there's a statue right there. So actually right behind me is the peace statue. And if you can tell, his hand pointing upwards is a warning of the atomic bombs coming down, and his left hand is a symbolization of peace, and also his eyes are closed, which symbolize like a prayerfulness state.
I spent my time watching the spaces that have grown between us, and I cut my mind on second best, all the scars that come with the greenness, and I gave my eyes to the boredom. Still the seabed wouldn't let me in, and I tried my best to embrace the darkness in which I swim. Now walking back down this mountain, the strength of a turning tide, oh, the wind so soft at my skin, yeah, the sun so hot upon my side, all looking out at this happiness. I search for between the sheets, or feeling blind, to realize all I was searching for was me. Oh, oh, all I was searching for was me.
So this little memorial here actually translates to an individual who was so thirsty that they wanted to drink water after the atomic bomb happened, and there was oil along the water, but they were so thirsty that they drank the water and unfortunately it was too dirty. So this is actually the remains of a prison that was standing when the bomb hit, and these concrete walls were 4 meters high and they obviously kind of reduced to their foundations. So this sign here actually explains the extent of the damage caused by the bombing. Here's a map that indicates so. So completely destroyed and burned, completely burned, half destroyed. They're all color coded there. It was actually dropped at an altitude of 30,000 feet or about 9,000 meters. Also here's some statistics of the damage caused by the bombing as well. So I actually just ran into a fellow vlogger. Her name is Jamie. She's also vlogging sightseeing stuff in Japan. So check out her channel and have a blow. So there's been so many sculpture pieces donated and placed in different parts of the park from many countries like Bulgaria, Germany, Spain, Brazil, Australia, and many more. And they're all donated to symbolize peace, harmony, and hope towards this tragedy that occurred. Leaving the Peace Park, I'm actually heading to the central location where the bomb actually hit Nagasaki. So I actually dropped the bomb 500 meters from ground level, and about one third of the Nagasaki city was actually destroyed, and 1,500,000 people were either killed or injured. And it's also an important fact to remember that about 70% of those people who were either injured or killed were children, women, or elderly citizens. So we're actually inside the Nagasaki Atomic Bomb Museum. So they've got a countdown of the years by fives until 1945. And it's like a spiral all the way down to the entrance. So this wall clock was actually found in a house right next to the hypocenter of the explosion, and the clock was actually shattered by the blast, and as you can see, its hands stopped exactly at 11:02 when the blast occurred. So this is the mushroom cloud after the bomb had happened. So this water tank was actually standing 800 meters away from the hypocenter, and as you can see, it has contorted legs from the blast. So this is a replica size of the Fat Man atomic bomb. Has a length of 3.25 meters, a weight of 5.5 ton, diameter 1.52 meters. So the explanation for the black painted along here is actually sealant, which ensures that the atomic bomb was airtight.
So we're actually just eating dinner right now, but that's it for today's video, everyone. Thank you for watching. If you're enjoying the content, make sure to give me a thumbs up. And also, if you have any questions about this adventure, put a comment down below. And thank you for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.